Status of the DACA program could still be up in the air. The program recently restored following a judge's order last week.
But its future could rest on a lawsuit filed right here in our state. Here's Channel 5's Thumbi Verma.
The uncertainty of DACA has taken a toll on many dreamers, not sure whether they could be deported in the future.
Every day I think of if we have to leave our home, a place that is ours.
Now Hernandez is concerned about a legal battle that started 2 years ago, right here in Texas. Originally, Texas was joined by six other states: Alabama, Arkansas, Louisiana, Nebraska, South Carolina, and West Virginia, in a suit against the federal government looking to force it to end the program. Other states have since joined in the suit, and the next hearing is set for December 22nd. The Mexican American Legal Defense and Educational Fund is representing the Dreamers.
So one outcome would be that the judge agrees with us that the states have failed, the plaintiff states have failed to show any kind of injury at all resulting from DACA, and the judge dismisses the case for lack of standing. Another possible outcome is that the judge decides that the questions of DACA's legality require a trial.
Texas Attorney General Ken Paxton filed the original suit, his website saying, "President Obama used DACA to rewrite federal law without congressional approval. Our lawsuit is vital to restoring the rule of law to our nation's immigration system." Then, when the U.S. Supreme Court ruled to uphold the DACA program this past June, he released another statement that said in part, "We look forward to continuing litigating that issue in our case now pending in the Southern District of Texas." Paxton also claiming Dreamers put strain on the economy. The defendants disagree.
There's zero evidence in this case of funds being spent by states on DACA.
As for Hernandez, he's worried that if he loses DACA, he'll lose his restaurant license. That means his employees would also suffer.
My restaurant is providing jobs for families, people who don't have anything.
Perales does say that no matter what happens in the hearing on the 22nd, things could ultimately change again under the incoming administration. Thanvi Verma, Channel 5 News at 6.